I started this when I was about 23 years old, and it just went, it skyrocketed. And so what mattered more than anything was that I didn't believe any of that. That I just, that's all in the past, that's somebody else, and I'm just continuing to go forward as if nothing ever happened, and I'm challenging myself and I'm trying. Because if I believed all the shit that has been written about me, like the, you know, the leading this and the leading that, you start believing your own press and you're in trouble.
What is Robert Lee Morris?
It's basically a reflection of me. And that's, to me, what qualifies as bona fide design, bona fide art. I was very torn between an anthropology major and an artist. What archaeologists do is they study the things that are left behind by previous cultures. And it's through the study of artifacts, the things that are left behind by the craftsmen in most cases, that they're able to put together the pieces of the puzzle of what the culture was about. So I suddenly saw myself being an artifact maker. So if I'm making a necklace, a gold necklace, in the back of my mind, I'm saying, all right, this gold necklace is going to probably end up in somebody's tomb or some who knows where. And 100 years from now, they're going to dig it up and they're going to examine it and they're going to be able to tell something about the times that we lived in. I hadn't really made my mind up to be a jewelry designer for quite a while. It was just something I was playing with and testing. And by the time I found myself in New York City with it, the reaction of the press, of the fashion editors and the stylists, it was such an overwhelming embracing of what I was doing that it was a wake-up call. I had been discovered at a craft fair by a very prominent gallery owner. This was Joan Sonnabend. And Sculpture to Wear was, I think, the thing that really turned it all on for me. It was jewelry by very famous artists that most people don't even know about. Picasso, Man Ray, Arp, Max Ernst, all the great ones, Braque, Miro, they all did some kind of jewelry. And in that jewelry, everything about that artist came forward. And so I said to myself, oh my God, this is who I am. This is what I want to do. And I'm not famous for anything else yet, but I want to use jewelry as my primary medium of art. When Sculpture to Wear closed, I actually opened my own shop at that time in 1977.
Where, here in New York?
In New York. And it was called Artware, and it lasted for nearly 20 years. If you were to be represented in Artware, your jewelry had to look exactly like you. It had to be groundbreaking. I showed my own work, but I also showed the work of about 30 other people internationally. And over the 20 years of Artware, I showed over 400 different designers.
From all over the world?
From all over the world. Most of the people that I represented worked in materials that were not considered jewelry materials. Silk impregnated with silicone rubber. Painted leather. Jewelry made of plastic. Jewelry made of niobium and titanium and exotic materials that were colored. And a great deal of brass, copper, steel, and oxidized materials. Green jewelry. Brown jewelry.
So was it you that created all that mess that happened after that?
Yes. I maintain the belief that jewelry should empower you and connect you to a spiritual level that is, you know, it's there, it's always there. And in some cases what it is it reminds you of your connection with your ancestors. The ironic thing about it is that we became very well connected with fashion, and every fashion designer around the world came through and started to collaborate with various artists that I represented, I being the one who collaborated more than anyone. Jeffrey Bean was one of the first big names. I won my first Coty Award with Calvin Klein for doing, and this was jewelry that was big and bold. Once I began working with Donna Karan, and all hell broke loose, and I started doing all of this very high fashion stuff for her, and it was integrated into this. We were defining American sportswear, and we were causing a real influence in both the fashion market and the jewelry market. When I have a day where I can just sit here and make, I go into this state of bliss, you know, this flow, where hours pass by in seconds, and I realize that I'm doing the one thing in the world that makes me happier than anything.
You're lost in your art.
Yes, and I'm just creating. And next thing I know, I've created, without any effort, I've created a new collection. And that's because I wasn't using my brain, I was using my heart. And I was open to whatever the inspiration was that came to me for that particular collection. It was moving me. It was the thing that was guiding me. And that's a state of bliss, and that's what art is to me. When Donna and I get together, it is magic, sheer magic. The chemistry between us, everyone in the room disappears. She and I are like two little kids playing with, the greatest new toys. The process is that I'll start with the idea that I want to make something that looks like a zipper. So that's the one driving thought for this collection. And I'll start carving wax parts. As the parts come back to me clean and I start to integrate them and put them together, I see where a new part can come in or a new shape, and it just reveals itself to me. So I make new models and then new models. Next thing you know, I've got a table full of all these new parts, which are kind of like all these letters in a new alphabet. And what I'm creating now is a new language. And that's, to me, the best part of the whole thing, is because this language will speak to someone else. They can see it without my explaining
it. It's a universal language.
Right, because it's like a universal consciousness. One of my rich customers from New Jersey came in one day with her bracelet to have the clasp fixed because she dropped it down the toilet in the airplane bathroom when she was wiping herself. And what happened?
No kidding.
No.
That's a story you'd rather not tell.
And brought it into me because she said, you know what? I was not going to let this thing go.